So good morning, everyone. Welcome to my session about continuous deployment on infrastructure platform and application services across bare metal containers and VM. It's like pretty long.
Yeah.
Our marketing team helped me to create this nice title. So basically what I want to demonstrate today is a new Mirantis cloud platform. So as you probably know, Mirantis recently released new platform which covers OpenStack, but not just OpenStack, but it covers Kubernetes, Stacklight as a monitoring. We have DevOps portal with cloud and intelligence, and we bringing much more than just before when it was just deployment tool. Now we're focusing more on day two, lifecycle management, and bringing operators the tools. And because I don't want to do so much like vendor style demo where I will push the button and show you the installer and this kind of stuff, I want to map it more to the use cases, because we pretty much focusing now on the tune stack with the use cases for users. And today I want to demonstrate how actually cloud users or operators or application developers can manage their complex pipeline on top of Mirantis cloud platform using Spinnaker. So let me take through the demo architecture. So what I have here, what's running under the hood is basically I have my Kubernetes cluster with Contrail CNI plugin, and then I have my OpenStack cluster with Open Contrail as a backend. And what I will do, I will basically start pod on the, I will pick some use case, in this case like big data use case, which some maybe who was on the keynote this morning saw what we did. So I want to go more deep here and show where it's running. So in the container I will have Kafka, and on the VM I will simulate like running Spark, and I will plug them through the single network, through the single SDN backend. And all this I will do through the Spinnaker. So I will trigger the pipeline, you will see the notifications and all parts running, and after that I will show you the underlay config. So let me go on my demo. So here I have my hybrid multi-cloud application, and Spinnaker provides you clusters, which are basically instances or container pods, and then you can manage load balancers, security groups, and other resources. So as you can see here, I can create either Kubernetes or OpenStack virtual machines. Right, so I can start my cluster with any image or any container and orchestrate it natively on top of any provider. And because I want to show you some complex pipeline, what I have here, I pre-configured my pipeline, which actually starts as a trigger for new Docker registry container. So you can have many triggers, Git, Docker, so anything can trigger your orchestration. So then I have two steps. The first steps I am actually calling deploy my Zookeeper container. So I will be deploying my application. So if we take a look how it looks, so I'm basically picking my container and I am saying I want deployment, and capacity will be 3 instances. And here I have find the image, because Spinnaker offers you 2 options. You can either find the image in the cloud, or you can bake your image directly. So you can through the Jenkins like build the image with application and just start it. So in this case I will just reuse the image, and I will trigger things which will start my VM here. And you can see flavors, security groups, load balancers, user data. So driver offers you pretty much multiple features. You can even pick the strategy how you want to do the upgrades, right? This is the biggest advantage of this tool, that you can like not just like power off and start, but do one by one or Highlander and other. And then I will deploy the Kafka. And each stage in this case will have notification to my Slack. Yeah, and I forgot to start my Slack. So what you should see here will be, and I wonder what you will see. Where is it? Hybrid Spinnaker. Right, so here you should see a notification from the Spinnaker after every stage. So now let's go on the pipeline, and one more thing before I will launch it is this. So here I have OpenStack dashboard, and this is the view on the stacks, and here I have view on my instances, right? So I am running some couple of instances here, and here I have my cluster, my Kubernetes cluster. I have just like terminal window screen here, and as you can see, I have two Kubernetes nodes and one master, so just small cluster. If we check the pods, I am running here two pods. One is Kube Network Manager, which is service which actually use OpenContrail to watch Kubernetes API and orchestrate the SDN backend. But this is what I have running here. So now let's go into Spinnaker and manually trigger the orchestration. And we can see the stages, how he is going. So now in same time, it's starting Zookeeper and Spark VM. So let's go here and check this. See, so what Spinnaker actually does, it creates the autoscaling groups. So you need to have Ceilometer as a backend, and it can like do the autoscales. So it brings similar feature like on AWS, and you can see that I started very, very briefly the instance with scale down and scale up policy. So I can actually scale up my cluster in any time, right? So my instance on OpenStack were started. Let's check here. Yes, and you can see that I am running three Zookeeper instances. So very quickly, I generated template and I started the deployment on Kubernetes. And if we check here, we see that this goes into green stage. Here is probably still some validation. Like after every stage, yeah, succeed. And now I am going into last stage when I will deploy the Kafka. And what we can check here is, as you can see, I'm getting the messages. So here I am getting default messages, what are there. But you can put your own messages on names or whatever. I just generated some bot, created the channel, and I am pushing the message with every stage into Spinnaker. So this is very cool because you can either integrate with your Jenkins, right? So you can compose your complex pipeline across multi-clouds, even across AWS or Google Cloud Engine, and spread your application and manage whole lifecycle. And you can mix VMs with the containers because not everyone can just like go and jump on the containerized stack. So running last stage, let's check the pods, yes. And Kafka is running. So you can see that very easily I manage all the application. Pipeline will be green in a couple of seconds. So now let's take a look if I have connectivity between the pods behind, right? Because I am running Contrail as a SDN. So let's pick one of the containers here. Check the IP address, right? So I have some random IP address what was assigned. As you can see, I don't have any access anywhere. So it's like completely isolated container. And here I have, so let's refresh the instance list. to see what IP got my virtual machine. Here we go, 2 minutes ago. This is the IP of my VM. Yes, and we are pinging. So what you can see here, that OpenContrail on the background orchestrated the connectivity between two totally isolated private networks, and I have direct overlay tunnel between my container and my virtual machine, and I don't need any extra gateway, any router, nothing. The connectivity is direct. So this is how it looks on front. And now let's take a look on the background from the network perspective. So what I have here, so here is my, yes, so you can see that I have not so small cloud, so like 740 instances, which is our OpenStack cloud. So this is Contrail running under the OpenStack. I am not using single OpenContrail, but I could use single one, but in this demo I decided to have two and federate them across each other to do not dependent on single control plane, but has two control planes. So this is the view, and here I can go under the networking. And this is the network where my Spinnaker provisions. And the reason why I have connectivity is this, because I am peering those contrails next to each other, and I just pick two same root target, which actually make happen that connectivity works in the background. And here I have my small OpenContrail cluster for my Kubernetes. And as you can see, I have just two vRouters, which are my two Kubernetes nodes, right? And what I can do, I can go into the networking and check the same thing, that here I have my network. And as you can see, I have same root targets here as well. And the way how it works is that I just very easily in BGP routers at the external control node. So Contrail use on standard network protocols. So they just like peer each other. So you can peer with this physical box, but you can also peer between clusters, right? So as same way as you build like multi-region cloud with OpenStack, where Contrails peer each other, you can build Kubernetes cluster, OpenStack cluster, whatever. So this is how looks the networking behind. And now we are going in my final stage of this demo. So what I want to show you as the last piece is how I can very easily scale up my, for instance, Kafka to 4, right? Because we're running 3, you can see here, running 3 instances. If I go back, do get pods, I have my 3 Kafka instances. I want to scale up. So very easily, I will go here and do the resize. Let's put number 4, submit, and there are 4. It was so fast. Yeah, there are 4. So this is the new one, right? So this way I can very easily scale. And if I want to just add the load balancer on top of the application, I can go here, create load balancer in Kubernetes, put some name, and actually I cannot remember the it's Zookeeper port. And I can even assign external IP address or load balancer. In this case, I can do this. And this should very easily generate the, yes, this should define the service definition inside of Kubernetes cluster. So that's pretty much it from the live demo, what I wanted to demonstrate of the hybrid platform. So I show you how very easily you can orchestrate on top of Mirantis Cloud platform any your applications, and that we are doing more than just like install OpenStack and tell user here is your OpenStack and that's it. So if you have any questions, I can answer them. Okay, so no questions. So thank you very much for your attention.